guys, and welcome back. Well, it was a story on CNN today, and I wanted to share you with it because it really got my attention. Now, it's about this Army veteran, father of two. His name was Everett Palmer Jr. And in April of last year, he called his brother and told him that he was on his way from Delaware to New York to visit him and his sick mother. He's told them, but first he had to stop in Pennsylvania to make sure that his license was valid. He had an outstanding DUI warrant for an incident in 2016, and he wanted to make sure that that was off his record and it was valid for him to drive. Now, that was the last call that the family ever heard from Mr. Palmer again. Now, 2 days after that call, they got a call from police at the York County Prison and told them that, their brother and son was dead. And he died while in their custody. Now, 14 months later, the Palmer said they still don't know what really happened. But they are suspicious because when they returned Palmer's body to his family, it was without his throat, heart, and brain. The throat, heart, and brain were missing out of the body. Now, they hired this civil rights attorney. His name is Lee Merritt. And he feels that this entire case is a cover-up. Now, the family hired Merritt because no one could answer their questions. The prison and county officials would not cooperate. Now, the initial autopsy by the York County Coroner's Office stated that Palmer died after an incident following an excited state during which he began hitting his head against the inside of the cell door and was restrained. Now, the report says Palmer became agitated as a result of methamphetamine toxicity, a probable sickling red cell disorder as listed as a contributing factor. Now, according to his family, Palmer never had any health problems leading up to his death. Now, they also say the autopsy report of him hitting himself are completely out of his character. Now, the York County Coroner Office updated its autopsy in July 28, 2018 to include a manner of death, which it listed as undetermined. Now, the autopsy report says details of the autopsy may be corrected as more information becomes available. Now, the family said Palmer did have some history of drug use, but never meth. Now, prison processing reports made available to the family provided no indication that Palmer was under the influence or had any drug paraphernalia listed in his items when he arrived. Now, he would have had to receive meth in the jail itself. We don't believe that happened, said the Palmer's attorney. Now, when the Palmer's body was returned to his family, but it was only after the family hired their own independent forensic pathologist that they discovered Palmer's body was missing three body parts. Now, their attorney says it's not unusual to take organs out of a body during an autopsy, especially if you believe they were subject to trauma. The highly unusual part is misplaced. Now, for 7 months, the family could not track down Palmer's brain, heart, or throat. They say they were told by the York County Coroner to check with the funeral home for the body part. And the funeral home said they haven't touched the body. Now, the family said they were later told by the coroner that the body parts were at an independent lab. However, the lab refused to hand over the parts. citing an ongoing investigation. Now, the family attorney believes the body parts will reveal details of how Palmer died, but we haven't been able to get them back. Now, his constitutional rights are being violated. Wow. Now, CNN reached out to the York County District Attorney Office for comments, and we're told the Office of the District Attorney does not comment on pending or ongoing investigations. Now, when asked how long the investigation to a case like this typically takes, they just told him every investigation is unique. This has got to be very taxing on that family. But now, according to the autopsy report on the morning of his death, Mr. Palmer was taken to a medical clinic where he was noted to be unresponsive. He was transferred to York Hospital where he was pronounced dead at 5:46 a.m. Now, if he was being processed for something that he did wrong in terms of a DUI, he should be held accountable for that, but it shouldn't be a death sentence, certainly inside of a jail, his brother added. We know that there are good people in the prison system. We appeal to them to come forward and share what they know. Now, the Palmer family has put in a Freedom of Information Act request for any video recordings from the York County prison while Palmer was in custody. Now, it's been over a year and we want some answers. The Palmer family says he was delivered back to us without organs. We want closure. If something criminal happened, and I believe something criminal did happen, we want the people that was involved in that to be held accountable. Wow. That blows my mind. I don't know about y'all, but I mean, really? I mean, what do you think? I mean, I really feel that there was cover-up. And without those organs, you can't pin down what really happened to this man. But the thought of them doing this, what did they think? That, I guess when they returned the body, they just felt like they wouldn't know. The funeral home would not be looking for it. The family would just take the autopsy report and be on their merry way. I don't know what they thought, but this is horrendous. I mean, it really is. I mean, hey, let's press that comment button and let's talk about this. I mean, why do you think they would send this man body back to his family without his organs? Have they sold him? What? All right, guys, good topic to get some exposure to this case and maybe some justice as well. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching my video. Hope you will like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And as always, important, be blessed, y'all.